Welcome to Rick's Corner, brought to you by Old School Labs, the brand I trust and the only one I put my name to. Use my code Drayson12 on the link below.
Welcome to Rick's Corner, the man, the myth, the legend. Now on with the show.
Welcome to Rick's Corner. I got John Hart from Mr. America, and we're talking about things like pro-hormones and drugs and muscle enhancement pills and this and that. We're going to get into that, but I first want to know about what your feeling are on the supplements.
On supplements such as like testosterone boosters or just general?
Well, that's one of them. You know, like protein powders and testosterone boosters and fat burners and that type of stuff, because supplements are made to be supplements. It means you take them in between a meal.
Yes.
It's not a meal within itself.
Yes.
Unless you're doing nutriment that they give the people 90 years old for a meal because they won't eat.
Yes.
So back in the days, we had very little supplements.
Yes.
They had Wieder's protein, and I think that was about it. Maybe liver pills. That was pretty much it.
Well, as a natural guy, you know, in the last... as a natural guy, you know, in the last couple of decades especially... You know, as I got into my late 30s and then my 40s and my 50s, it became more important that I supplemented. You know, it felt bad if I didn't. You know, having a good whey protein, having, you know, at one point liver pills. I still was using desiccated liver tablets, you know, Argentinian, you know, into, you know, my 40s. Having those amino acids now that exist, having... even simple things that you think about, you know, citrulline, amino acids have different purposes.
And yes.
And so I've used and experimented with things like that, and a lot of them have been very helpful, I think. And then at the same time, there's so much garbage out there. We've done an entire show on supplements before, right?
Right.
Where there's so much garbage. So you have to be diligent about it, experiment with it. And then I'm a big believer in creatine. I won't lie to you. That's there's been so much research on it, and I've had such great results with it.
Do you do a loading phase on creatine?
I've done both.
Or you just start out and just go through the week?
When I was younger, I did a loading phase. Now, no. I just go with it 5 grams a day. On workout days, I'll do 10 grams. And then...
What do you notice from the creatine?
Within 1 week, there's a strength jump, and there's a fullness to the muscle.
Interesting.
And I do not retain fluid from it. I'm one of those, you know, some people out there claim they retain a lot of fluid from it. I'm not. And my weight does jump up an immediate 4 or 5 pounds. It takes, if I'm not loading on it, it'll take about 3 weeks for that to happen. If I am loading on it, 1 week later, I'm
up. Do you know how many people, not to interrupt you, that...
It's okay. You do it all the time.
I do, because I need to make my point, because if I don't say it, I'll forget. How many people have come to me and they take creatine thinking it's a steroid?
Yes.
It has nothing to do with steroids.
No, it absolutely doesn't.
Doesn't creatine come from red meat?
That's creatine is a major component in red meat. And, you know, back in the day, it's an explanation as to why all the red meat that you used to eat made bodybuilders feel so strong. Everybody knew, strong men knew, it made them strong.
Yeah.
And even to this day, they know it makes them strong. So, but it takes like 2.5 pounds of that red meat to consume the same amount of creatine you would get in one fat teaspoon.
I know.
5-6 grams. So that to me is, it's a trade-off. If you're a regular meat eater, interestingly enough, you don't get a really big push from using creatine because you already have some in your system.
Yeah.
You see? So for me, I'm not a big red meat eater, although I eat red meat. And it there's a difference. I like it.
I think I get red meat like once a week now. I used to have it almost every day.
Mm.
And not for any particular reason. It's just I just don't eat it. Like today at lunch, I had salmon.
Yes.
Last night, I had Thai food with chicken.
Yeah.
Tonight, I'll probably have chicken. I don't know. I'd like a good steak once in a while, but nearby, I don't find anything that really sets me off. So I'll do the chicken and the fish, and I think the fish is pretty darn good, although I feel very light when I'm on fish.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Digestively, I think that's undeniable. You're going to feel a little bit heavier eating the red meat versus fish. I like it still, and I do eat it, you know, 3, 4, 5 times a week. But otherwise, I go in phases. Sometimes I have none at all.
It's weird how that works, because there was a time when I would have a beef patty for lunch every day and two at night on my hibachi barbecue.
Yes.
And that's when I had my best gains, so I'm eating those 3 beef patties a day.
Well, this was pre-creatine.
Oh, yeah.
There was no supplement. That no, was your no, supplement of creatine. Yeah, there you
exactly.
go.
Exactly. But, you know, as time changes for us and for you guys that are getting older out there, your appetite and your taste in foods changes. You don't have the same taste buds you had at 50 or 60 that you had at 30.
Yes.
And you start to eat something and say, you know, this isn't what it used to be, unless the quality isn't what it used to be.
Right.
And so then you don't really feel like eating. So I'll have lunch, like I'll have scrambled eggs and cottage cheese yesterday. I figured that's good. And then I come home and I didn't eat till like 7:30, and I thought, I need something in between. And that's where the supplement comes in.
Right.
Normally I'll take some amino acids and stuff, but now I've been doing liver pills and amino acids just to have something in my system.
From old school?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think it helps a lot. But if you look at my supplements in there, I got about 20 bottles on my counter.
Mm-hmm.
People are going to walk in my door and say, true. What the hell are you doing in there?
Yes.
But, you know, you have your pre-workout, then you have a vegetable that's a instant greens, and you have other things, and I take them all in the morning with my egg whites from Egg White International, and I mix it up and I drink it down. Well, that's not solid food, but at least it gets into my system.
Yes.
And then I back that up with oatmeal and sliced bananas. So I have something solid.
And as long as those supplements are not like causing you bloating or gas, you know, that's a problem, right? I mean, back in the day, we knew all of that. You know, if you had a certain protein powder and you instantaneously had bloating and gas, you knew it was garbage, you know? And then every once in a while, you'd get a hold of a good quality company and supplements and you'd use it. And they were very absorbable and easy to break down. And there were no problems. And you felt like it actually accentuates your training. It helps you with your look. It doesn't make things go south. So that's a big deal for me. As I as time has gone on, I don't want to waste time.
Yeah.
You know, so I go with the things that I know. The whey protein, the creatine, you know, the amino acids. If there's some newfangled, you know, supplement out there, I let everybody else play with it first and then let me see the research.
Do you do the creatine before workout?
If I'm going
to, after
a workout, primarily, if you know, if I'm going to work out, I'll do it 5 grams before and 5 after, actually, and then if on non-workout days, it'll just be 5 grams.
You know, I used to think like that, but then I started thinking that non-workout days are just as important as workout days.
Absolutely.
So those are the days you're resting, and your body needs all those nutrients.
Yeah,
and you need to eat. It's kind of weird to understand, but if you eat more, you end up losing more body fat. If you eat properly,
that's a good metabolism when you
that's
do
a good
that.
Metabolism. Yeah. That's how it works. I saw a guy in the gym, and I was saying, "Gee, you look really good." Some young kid. He says, "Oh, yeah." He says, "This diet." He says, "I'm eating more than I ever have, but I'm getting in better shape and dropping fat." I said, "That's exactly how it works." But you can't get the average person on the street to understand that.
No, that's if clean eating too.
It's yeah, that's eating. Clean eating. They think if I'm eat that much, I'm going to get fat. No, if you're eating clean, you won't.
Right. That's right.
So
you have to have a decent amount of calories, and it gets proven every single time somebody starts tracking their food, eating better.
Yeah.
Kaboom! It happens overnight. They start building muscle, losing some fat.
You need calories to burn, and then when you're sleeping at night, that's when those building blocks start working on your body. Mm. These little guys with hammers and chisels are inside your bloodstream, like, okay, let's build some muscle down here in the bicep today.
Yeah. And I find it convenient too. Like at night, like a last meal of the day, if I'm hungry. Or if I know I still can afford the calories and all, I'll have some peanut butter and, you know, a scoop of protein powder. And I like just chewing on the peanut butter or sucking on the peanut butter and then slam down a scoop of protein powder before I go to bed. I like that. It's convenient. It's quick. It's easy. And, you know, again, if you're with a company that doesn't bloat you up, then you're good.
I'm addicted to peanut butter. I love peanut butter on anything. I just like it.
Yeah. That's good.
I don't eat a lot of it, but I do eat it pretty much daily.
Yes.
Nighttime, I don't do this anymore. I don't eat after 7 o'clock. And there's no reason for it. It's not that I'm not going to. I'm just not hungry. So I'll have a big glass of ice water, about 8 or 9, and put it down by the TV and watch maybe a movie or a show, and I'll just sip my ice water. Keeps me totally satisfied. Then I'll have my fiber at bedtime, which is orange-flavored, and I'll mix it with vanilla protein, which tastes like a Orange Julius.
That's right. I remember.
It's pretty good. But years ago, we used to go to the deli at night about 10:30, 11 o'clock. We'd have cheese omelets.
Yeah.
And that's what we go to sleep on.
Yeah.
Cheese omelets.
Yeah. You got to have a little bit of protein, a little bit of fats in there.
Well, they built muscle. It definitely built muscle.
Yeah.
And people laugh at me. Why do you always eat cheese omelets and cottage cheese? Because it's proven that it works. They said, yeah, but you're not new school. You're old school. Things have changed. No, they have not.
No.
Your body has not changed in the past several hundreds of years. The body is the body. It responds to whatever you put into it. If it worked for me 50 years ago, it works for me now too, because it's the same body.
Yeah.
There's no way around it.
Yeah. Yeah.
So people are saying, well, are you natural? We just talked about, are you natural? I am natural. No, I mean, I haven't taken anything in years because I don't feel that I need to. I'm not going to compete. Right. And I've got nothing to prove. Been there and done that. But I have to keep my calories a little higher, and I got to keep my protein higher. And I train medium weight, not heavy weight, just through the injuries, and I seem to retain size. Someone said, oh, you were so much bigger back then. I said, not really. I mean, I weighed about 215, 212. Now I'm 222. Mm-hmm. It's a different shape because I was just thicker because I was training heavy.
Right.
But I don't care at my age. I'm not trying to impress anybody.
Well, and that's what happens is, you know, decades go by.
Yeah.
Things change. Your priorities change. I've had people say to me online, you know, question me, you know, over the years, oh, you were bigger during this time period. First of all, they're looking at pictures that they don't know when they were really from.
That's right.
I put the picture up. I said, you know, this is what I look like. I didn't say it was from this time period or whatever.
Right.
So if they want to go ahead and try to put the pieces together, that's fine, right? But when they say things like try to chronologically put things together, I laugh because you kind of have to go, well, yeah, I would hope that 33-year-old me had an advantage over 53-year-old me in some ways. But then again, at 53, I know that up here, I could beat the crap out of 33-year-old me.
How do you think I feel at 75? I mean, I know that I'm far better off at 75 than I was at 35, especially experience and knowledge, because I've gained a lot over those years.
Yeah.
But I have injuries, and so it's hard to train the injuries. And some guys will say, you're just an old man. But guess what? You're going to get there.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's going to get older. Yeah. And I like to see 90% of these people who tell me that training at my age, I'm sure they won't be.
No, most people are done.
They're done.
They're finished. And
they're done by 50, 60 years old. Yeah, it's just over.
You know, and you just brought it up. When we talk about, you know, the concerns that, you know, people have, are you natural or you're not natural? Did you ever use? Did you not use? You know, things like that. I know that there's a curiosity.
Right? Yeah.
You know that. Yeah. Over the years, we've both had lots of questions over the years. You know, and I've competed as a natural athlete, you know, it's been the last, I've competed for 25 or 30 years now. And, you know, when someone sees a picture of you ripped up on stage.
What were you on?
I mean, for real. Yeah. For real. Let's just address that one right now. Okay, you see how I just got a little dramatic, right? You go ahead and take a look at me. After I walk off the stage and I'm falling out of my sweats, okay? I mean, falling out, dehydrated, at my lowest possible body weight. Yeah, you look like an anatomy chart when you take it off. Yeah, my wife was like, wow, all day long. But in clothes, I was at Gold's Gym and Rico, he's training with Flex. Remember Rico training with Flex, right?
Yeah.
McClintock? And Rico says to me, are you okay? I said, why? And he goes, you look like you might be a little sick. And he didn't know I was competing, but this was all sunk in.
Oh, yeah.
I was looking kind of thin. It was the middle of the winter.
Yeah.
I'm wearing full sweats. I wasn't tan. We put the fake stuff on.
Yeah.
You know, so here he is asking me, am I okay? That's how thin, as a natural, in your clothes, you would get. You see? So when they'd ask, see pictures and they make comments like that, I just kind of go, well, I have to have a little bit of sympathy in a way of just saying, well, they don't know.
No, they don't know. But the thing is, I have a friend that's, well, you know, Doug.
Yeah.
He's got a contest coming up. He looks really, really
Brignoli.
Good. Yeah, he looks really good. He's got to lose another few pounds here and there, and he's just ripped. But what people don't realize is it's all about gaining weight. It's not about gaining weight. When you compete, it's all about losing weight.
Right.
The less you weigh and the more less body fat you have, the bigger you look.
The bigger you look under those lights, you get up on the stage, you're going to look sick and skinny. Even guys that are using drugs, they look almost ill.
Yeah.
Unless you're talking about professional bodybuilders. Most of the amateurs look ill. So how old is Doug now?
58.
Wow.
He looks good.
God bless him. God bless him.
He's putting a lot into it, and he looks really, really good. This probably might be his last contest, but he wants to go out with a bang, which I don't. That's fine.
Nah, yeah, that's cool. Of course. He's had a great career. So tell me this: we were talking before we got on the air about the pro hormones.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So what did you know about them from back then?
I know that somebody back in Florida sent me 3 bottles of pro hormones many, 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 many years ago. They said this works just like steroids; it's really good. And so I took a bottle, and I did notice a difference in my body, but it was not a steroid, but it's a derivative of the leftover trash they take out of the steroids, apparently.
And apparently it's pretty dirty on the liver.
Yeah, pretty dirty on the liver, and it's not really healthy for you.
Not regulated, right?
Not regulated, and you can buy it anywhere. They sold it in health food stores or whatever. And it worked, and then I thought, nah, I don't want to take it. So I gave the two bottles away. I did not want them.
See, and here's the thing. The man's telling the truth, right?
Yeah.
And I've been open about myself. People ask me, they say you're not natural. I go, look, I don't consider myself to be natural for life versus being natural because of the pro-hormones. Back in the 90s, remember, when was Mark McGuire, when did they find that out?
That's quite a while ago.
That's like mid-90s? I don't know. So whenever that was, during that era, see, I don't even remember when it was. We're talking about decades ago. And that insignificant portion of my life, right? One summer, messing around with pro-hormones, and put 5 pounds of muscle on. And I didn't feel so great afterwards. But, I never went to a doctor for it. They were right at the vitamin shop. You can go right into any health food store and get a hold of that stuff, right?
Yeah.
So doing that, for some reason, you know, in my mind, I've competed in natural shows by all of their rules. For the last 25 years, their rules are no drugs for 7 years. Pee test, urine test, lie detector, sometimes blood. Okay, what if off-season testing? That's the best. So they can catch people if they're using.
Sure.
So I've done all of that. And even in the midst of all of that, you know, you still have some ignorant people out there. I'm being kind here and saying this.
I don't want to call people names, but they don't think before they talk.
Yeah.
And I'm not for steroids, but I'm not against them either. If your body needs it and your doctor says it's okay, why not? But back in the 70s and back to the mid-80s, they were legal. They were not illegal.
Right.
And you could get them from your doctor and you could take them. And no one frowned on you for it because it wasn't against the law. Then the FDA came in and made them illegal. They wanted their cut of the money.
Right.
And that's what it all came about. It had nothing to do with any other than the fact we want money off this stuff.
But the moment they made it illegal,
There
was a stigma attached
to it.
Right away. Oh, man. I mean, that's why you look the way you look.
Right.
Right? It has nothing to do with your lifestyle.
Nope.
Oh, a little hairball?
No, she's sneezing.
All right.
They want to attribute it to that.
Right.
Well, no wonder you look so good. You're taking steroids. Well, that's not the answer to all of it.
No.
The answer is good diet and hard training.
Yeah, you're bombing away in the gym.
That's just the tip of the iceberg before a contest for some of the guys.
Right.
And it just gives them a little bit of an edge. But it's not like a miracle drug. It just doesn't do that.
No.
If you take it, the guys today at the Olympia, the pros and what they're taking so much of everything you could possibly think of that's why they're over the top. And just recently, Flex Wheeler had to have his leg amputated.
Wow.
And I heard it was doing the insulin. So there are side effects to everything. And I don't want to be one of those guys. I'm at the age now where I want to live every moment and every day.
You're still in one piece.
Yep. Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
So yeah, man, you know, I don't mean to, you know, I can't say too much because, you know, if we keep on talking about it, it's like I'm the natural. I won the Mr. America when it was drug tested for 3 years in 2011, 12, and 13. I won in 13. I was drug tested, okay? I beat a bunch of guys that were also drug tested, okay? I won the actual Mr. America title, right? I won the Natural Mr. Universe, right? Back in the early 2000s.
Right.
I won my height class in that. Drug tested there, too. To this day, it amazes me that just, there's doubt and all that stuff. And I go, doubt all you want, but stop making excuses, you know, for perhaps a lack of effort. Or even genetics, right? I'm not saying I'm the most genetically blessed guy at all in any way, shape, or form. But at least get out there. Work harder, man.
Yeah.
You know, I tell my own son this, you know. Don't ever complain. If you're not starting on the football field, if you're not starting, you're not good enough. The coaches don't see you as being good enough.
No, there's one more thing I want to say before we close out because I said this yesterday on the Facebook is that I see guys come into the gym. The first thing they do is bench press.
Hmm.
Chest and then arms. And then they're done. They might throw a little back in once in a while, maybe not. Or they might throw some leg extensions in, maybe not.
Yeah.
But they're more concerned about their arms and their chest, how big they are when they leave the gym.
Mm.
And that has nothing to do with being in shape. That just, it's stupid already. It's like washing part of your car and not washing the rest of it. You want to train the whole body. You want the whole body to be symmetrical and be in shape. That means you have to work out every body part. Whether you hate legs or hate abs or whatever, you got to put the time in.
Yes.
If you don't put the time in, nothing's going to happen. By working your legs, it makes your upper body grow.
Mm-hmm.
It all works together. And it's not about what you take. It's about how hard you train and how good you eat. That is the whole key to everything. No one's going to notice a difference in 10 pounds on you if you take something or if you don't take something, as long as you're in good shape. They're just going to say, wow, that guy's in good shape.
Combine that, everything you just said, with some decent genetics.
Yeah.
Because there's some people that are just not meant for bodybuilding.
No, that's true.
Right? There's some people that they'll never be. They'll just never be that. No. And they should do something else. You know, reach your potential in whatever area. Or accept, when you do your bodybuilding, that you're not going to be that.
Right.
And just be the best that you can be.
Be the best you can be.
Right? Yeah. I mean, I always see that as being, you know, you win. Automatically, you win by being the best you can be.
You, you win just by getting to the gym.
There it is.
You know, it's good for your health. I go to the gym and I do my workout and then I do the bike for 10, 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. And then someone said, that's not enough to burn fat. I said, I'm not trying to burn fat. I'm doing my bike for my cardio, for my heart.
It's very assumptive on their part.
To keep my blood going and my leg moving and get blood into my leg where I had my injury. And so that's why I do the bike. But there's a reason for everything you do.
Well, dude, I tell you, I admire you. You show up every day to the gym. Every time this man, I come and do a show, you know, he gets out of that car and he's always coming from the gym.
Yeah.
So that's one of the things that, you know, I've admired about you from the beginning and your love of what you're doing.
I go limping and I limp and I limp and then I come back and the next day I go, I'm not limping. And then today my shoulder's killing me because I did something to it. But I think all of you guys go through that, different body parts they hurt from time to time. And you just kind of got to go with it. I can't sit home and just nurse it. I got to go and work it out.
Right,
that's what it's all about.
And you know what, too? I want to point out also before we go that you and I have always told the truth. We sit here and we talk about the truth, you know? And that's also important that, you know, some of you guys watching this know that that Rick has offered a lot of advice free on a regular basis.
Yeah.
But he's always pointing out the truth. He's always pointing out what has worked in the past for him. He gets guests on the show. By the way, I loved your Tony Pearson interview last week.
Good, yeah.
Loved it. Watch that show, Tony Pearson, man. Childhood idol of mine in bodybuilding. Fantastic bodybuilding. So, but you've always told the truth. If you ask me a question, I give him the truth. I came in here today after, you know, battling a little bit of traffic. I wasn't my usual 15, 20 minutes early sitting outside sleeping. So I came in a little bit heated. It was 100 degrees outside today. So a little bit heated. And when it came to subject matter, you know, we came in and right away started talking drugs and pro-hormones.
Well, because it's a whole conversation in the gyms and people assume that you're doing all this stuff when you're not. And it doesn't really matter. And plus, it's none of your business anyway.
Yeah. And look, I'm happy because I know my truth.
Right.
There you go. I know my truth. Yeah. You know, God knows my truth. You know, that throughout the years, I'm healthy, I'm happy, and I'm thankful to have, you know, competed and won certain titles that I always wanted as a kid. And I think that some of that was really orchestrated by God, that it wouldn't have happened otherwise. Think about that. Mr. America was not drug tested. Remember when you were coming up in bodybuilding and training with the boys in the 70s and the 80s? It wasn't drug tested.
No. But I think the biggest fear in people, even with bodybuilding and contests, is the fear of being rejected. Because, you know, there's a lot of judges that are just going to reject you. And the happiest thing you can do and the love you have is to be accepted.
Yes.
So you should be accepted for who you are and what you are and just be happy that you're able to do something. You may not be Mr. Olympia, but who cares? As long as you're you and you're a good you, that's all that matters.
Yeah.
And don't prejudge people. I see people in the gym that I could prejudge very easily. I see into things other people don't, and I don't do that because I know that behind them, there's something good about them. And I found that out recently on so many people when I talked to them, after I talked to them, they're all good people.
You know, when I was a trainer at Gold's Gym in Venice, I was there for about 14 years as a trainer. And I used to see one of the trainers there training his client, this little older lady, and she was a little bit overweight, you know. And I, speaking of, you know, don't judge, right? And I used to look and go, God, what I could do with that woman, get her in shape. He's taking her money. He's just ripping her off.
Oh, I see it all the time.
Right?
There's one, a lady in my gym's got to be 90, and the trainer's telling her, do this exercise, honey, and you're going to have amazing triceps.
Okay.
She's skinny, hunchback, little old lady. She didn't give a shit less about her triceps.
Right.
Why would you even tell her that?
Yeah.
And she's not going to have, she's got 9-inch arms.
Right. Right? And so I'd see this, right? And I would assume that he didn't know, you know, what he was doing and on it would go. Well, as the years went by, I noticed, I'm leaving names out of this. I remember both their names clearly. But as the years went by, I noticed he'd walk her out to her car. He'd hold her hand and walk out to her car. I thought, wow, that's really polite of him. Hey, he's a nice guy. He's polite, like this. Next thing you know, I see him helping to carry her out the in the gym and then out of the gym.
Really?
Yeah, she had MS.
Oh, right? My God.
And then next thing you know, she was hardly even functioning, and he'd still bring her in and bring her out with help.
Yeah.
With help. And she'd do whatever she could.
That's dedication.
Right to the end. And I went, man, look at me. I was judging them years ago. And I witnessed the whole thing progress to where it was like, this guy was a super champion helping this woman out at a time in her life when she really needed it. But on the surface, it looked like
That's quite a guy.
Yeah, man. And he's still there.
It's amazing to do that for somebody.
Yeah.
It's always nice to help somebody who's in need that needs help. And I'll see somebody in the gym and I'll look at him and almost talk to him and I'll talk to this guy. I said, my God, you look good. I've seen you all month and all of a sudden you put all this muscle on. Really? I said, yeah. I'm just telling you. I said, everybody can tell you something bad, but I'd rather tell you something good.
It lifts them up. It lifts
it
them
does.
Up.
It really helps a lot.
And that's also why, you know, when I get comments online, I got to tell you, you guys will notice on my channel, on Miss America Heart, please share my channel with them. I don't comment. If there's, you know, some nasty or hateful or, you know, comment thrown at me, I don't comment. You know, I wish you all peace, man. I wish you all love.
Well, those people that run the nasty, hateful comments, the other members on the channel, they always stick up for me.
Yeah. A couple have done for
you. You're always going to have that in the crowd. You're in high school or wherever you are, you're going to have two or three people who are just jerks, and they got to say something. But those are the guys that come up on losing and the stick in life.
Yeah.
They just don't care anymore.
No,
so they're take it out on you. Well, thanks, John.
Man, appreciate having me, Rick.
I can't move my arm. And thank you guys for watching Risk Corner. And I've got Corey Everson coming up towards the end of the week, so that'll be fun.
Am I scheduled that same day?
No, it's just me and her.
Are you sure?
See you guys next time.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody. I just wanted to introduce you to my new clothing line, Gym Bums of California. It's at yeahiworkout.com. YIWO.com. I have this and two other designs, plus shorts, tank tops, there's hoodies, there's all kinds of stuff. These are my designs from the 1980s that we brought back, a whole new Rick Grayson collection. Go to YIWO.com, go through it, you can order direct. They're all brand new with my signature, and you'll love it. Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed the video brought to you by Old School Labs. Use my discount code Grayson12 on the link below at oldschoollabs.com.
Hey everyone, now you can have the Gold's Gym logo drawn by me, the artist Rick Grayson, personalized and made out to you and signed by me to frame and put on your gym wall or wherever you see fit to do so. It's a piece of bodybuilding history. It will never be duplicated again. It's the largest selling icon t-shirt logo in the world. And I'm the guy that drew it. And I will draw it for you. Just go to my website, rickdrayson.com, and order there. You can pay through PayPal and it'll be sent out right away. And be sure to watch Rick's Corner for all the videos on bodybuilding, nutrition, fitness, pro wrestling, and anything that suits your interest as far as getting physically fit and being the best you can be from the golden era of bodybuilding.
Baby, see you next time.